I really do not know what to do with plastic. Cannot live without it and cannot stop feeling guilty about using it. For example, have you wondered how many non-degradable water bottles we throw in a year? Or milk and chips pouches for that matter? Do we realize how many non-degradable plastic is found in solid waste?
Yes, I understand. It's mind-boggling to even think of plastic waste everywhere. Soil, water, and oceans killing fishes, entering back in human bodies.
You are a chemical engineer. Can you explain where does this all plastic come from? And even though these are wonderful raw materials, which have changed the course of human history, why do they just not disappear as a banana peel does?
First, even a banana peel does not disappear or biodegrade, even after 1-2 years, according to the article included from The Guardian, because it contains cellulosic polymer. A polymer is a long chain of single molecules called monomers. Natural occurring polymers are hair, skin, oils, and proteins like collagen.
Really? Our hair, proteins?
Different types of polymers are used in packaging, also commonly known as plastics, made of oil and its derivatives. Oil was formed in sediments of sea and deep layers of earth as a result of 1,000 years of decay of vegetable and animal waste, thus contains long carbon chains.
Oh, so that's why I hear the term carbon footprint a lot by our corporate customers at our advertising agency.
All right. Why not ask our microbiologist friend, Monica, who seems to have finally come out of a lab at Biodeg.
Yes, why not?
Hi, how come you are here?
Hi, Aftab. Hi, Ashima. I had to meet the Secretary of Environment. They want to work on plastic waste.
Bingo! Ashima wanted to know about carbon footprints of plastics.
All vegetable and animals' waste decay, releasing water, manure, and gases like carbon dioxide or methane as a natural process. Rice fields and cattle are one of the biggest emitters of methane on this earth. Carbon on earth will remain in one form or the other. Carbon cannot vanish. So while discussing carbon footprint, we should really think through deeply.
Thanks for that, but I started with the plastic pollution.
See, first let me explain biodegradability. Microbes, our friends, survive best in two types of environment. In presence of oxygen called aerobic, or in absence of oxygen called anaerobic. In soil, oxygen is present till about several meters depth. And beyond that, it's mostly anaerobic. Landfills and big drains are mostly anaerobic. In nature, though there is no absolute line where one type of microbe vanishes and other is completely dominant.
Monica, why don't you tell her what does Biodeg does and how does it reduce plastic pollution?
Okay, it's many more stations to go. Our product, Biode, acts at two stages. First, Biode's proprietary organic material cuts the polymer chain to monomers below 3,000 molecular units, and thereafter it attracts different microbes towards the monomers to consume or mineralize these.
But I have a few questions. What are the end products? Are those toxic to the environment? Do Biode products biodegrade? Or are eaten by microbes completely?
You just took me to my next point. As it happens with vegetable or organic waste, microbes consume the monomers and produce water and manure. Any material which starts biodegrading does and will biodegrade 100% in time. Nature has no gray areas. It is either zero or one. There is a misconception that there would be a certain percentage or halfway of biodegradation. To put it simply and accurately, Biodeg makes all these packaging biodegradable. Biodegradability is nature's way of recycling.
Biodeg looks like a great product. I am surprised we did not talk about this earlier.
Haha, so am I. I should have told you about my work earlier. Then you could have biodegraded my brains.
Agla station, Green Park.
Next station is Green Park.
My station is there, so we will continue to talk about these exciting topics more. You two are great listeners. But do not pester me too much, else you know what else I can do. By the way, do you know, biodegradable products can be recycled without harming the recycling stream or metal?
Really? That's great! Because then biodegradable products do not have to be separated from non-biodegradable plastic.
Why don't you come to my lab someday and I will show you biodegradation under microscope. Bye!
To be continued.